Good morning and happy Easter. This is the second Sunday of Easter, and it's also Divine Mercy Sunday. As we prepare in advance for our celebration of Word and Eucharist, we would ask that you please turn off all silence or silence all electronic devices at this time. Jesus tells us to welcome the strangers so that there are no strangers in our midst. Please let us stand and extend a warm welcome to those around you.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Amen. My dear brothers and sisters, let us humbly beseech the Lord our God to bless this water he has created, which shall be sprinkled on us as a memorial of our baptisms. May he help us by his grace to remain faithful to the Spirit we have received. Lord our God, in your mercy, be present to your people's prayers, and for us to recall the wondrous work of our creation and still the greater work of our redemption, graciously bless this water. May it be for us a memorial of the baptism we have received, and grant that we may share in the gladness of our brothers and sisters who at Easter have received their baptisms through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Oh, yeah.
Almighty God, have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Glory to God, glory in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you.
God of everlasting mercy, who in the very recurrence of the Paschal Feast kindle the faith of the people you have made your own. In Christ we pray the grace you have bestowed that all may grasp and rightly understand in what font they have been washed, by whose Spirit they have been reborn, by whose blood they have been redeemed. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. The community of believers was of one heart and mind, and no one claimed that any of his possessions was his own, but they had everything in common. With great power, the apostles bore witness to the resurrection of the Lord Jesus, and great favor was accorded them all. There was no needy person among them, for those who owned property or houses would sell them, bring the proceeds of the sale, and put them at the feet of the apostles. And they were distributed to each according to need. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad. Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good, for his mercy endures forever. The right hand of the Lord has struck with power. The right hand of the Lord is exalted. The stone which the builders rejected has become the cornerstone.
A reading from the first letter of St. John. Beloved, everyone who believes that Jesus is the Christ is begotten by God. And everyone who loves the Father loves also the one begotten by him. In this way, we know that we love the children of God when we love God and obey his commandments. For the love of God is this, that we keep his commandments. And his commandments are not burdensome, for whoever is begotten by God conquers the world. And the victory that conquers the world is our faith. Who indeed is the victor over the world? But the one who believes that Jesus is the Son of God. This is the one who came through water and blood, Jesus Christ. Not by water alone, but by water and blood. The Spirit is the one who testifies, and the Spirit is truth. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Disciples were for fear of the Jews. Jesus came and stood in their midst and said to them, "Peace be with you." When he had said this, he showed them his hands and his side. The disciples rejoiced when they saw the Lord. Jesus said to them again, "Peace be with you. As the Father has sent me, so I send you." And when he had said this, he breathed on them and said to them, "Receive the Holy Spirit. Whose sins you forgive are forgiven them, and whose sins you retain are retained." Thomas, called Didymus, one of the 12, was not with them when Jesus came. So the other disciples said to him, "We have seen the Lord." But he said to them, "Unless I see the mark of the nails in his hands, and put my finger into the nail marks, and put my hand into his side, I will not believe." Now a week later, his disciples were again inside, and Thomas was with them. Jesus came, although the doors were locked, and stood in their midst and said, "Peace be with you." Then he said to Thomas, "Put your finger here and see my hands, and bring your hand and put it into my side. And do not be unbelieving, but believe." Thomas answered him and said, "My Lord and my God." Jesus said to him, "Have you come to believe because you have seen me? Blessed are those who have not seen, but have believed." Now Jesus did many other signs in the presence of his disciples that were not written in this book. But these are written that you may to believe that Jesus is Christ, the Son of God, and that through this belief you may have life in his name. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to the Lord Jesus Christ.
So good morning.
Good morning.
Happy second Sunday of Easter, and it's also what Sunday?
Divine
Mercy Sunday. That's why we have this photograph back here of the Lord Jesus. Divine Mercy is about the power of unconditional love of Jesus. So the scriptures today talk to us very loudly, this beautiful gospel we just had. So we've got Jesus being crucified on Friday, and the depiction today in the gospel today is the disciples are in the upper room on Sunday, only two or three days after the death of Jesus, and they're terrified, right? Because they've seen Jesus be killed, and they've seen what they did to him, and the Romans were expert at killing people, and they don't want it to happen to them. So they're in the upper room, the drapes are pulled, the doors are locked, and they're shaking, okay? And they're just terrified that this is going to happen to them. When who shows up? Jesus shows up. Isn't that cool? He didn't ring the doorbell or anything. He just came in. So one thing I like about that is, you know, when we pass away, we're going to have that same spiritual body, And you can go visit your family and friends and they won't even know you're there. Isn't that going to be cool to do that? They're probably right here, right now, watching us, okay? So one of the gifts of that. And the first thing Jesus says to the 11 apostles, and I also like to call them the 11 chickens, because they're afraid, right? They're all chicken of what's going to go on. Jesus talks to them, and what's the first words he says to them? Peace be with you. In Hebrew, it would be shalom. So Jesus says shalom to them, because he's trying to get them to relax. You know, take it easy, guys. And he says to them, whose sins you shall forgive, they're forgiven. And whose sins you don't, they're retained. So we priests for 2,000 years have had this special gift of forgiving sins for these 2,000 years, given by Jesus directly to the apostles, directly to the priests of 2,000 years, able to forgive sins. And the good news is seems to be a resurgence of people going to confession. So Father Michael and I were at confessions for hours and hours and hours, and Father Michael holds the world record of just before Easter, 5 hours in the confessional. So sin's coming back. Isn't that good news? All right. That is so good news. And finally people are sinning again. Thanks be to God. So we get to hear your sins. And there's still lots of people that don't go, and I'm convinced that what keeps them away is fear and anxiety and embarrassment. People don't want to go because they're afraid of what they're going to be saying. Father will remember me. You know, you go to confession to Father Tim, then you have to see him on Sunday, and you have to kind of... Okay, so we priests have a special gift. We have a divine washing machine for our brains. What is it? A divine washing machine where you get to wash away what we hear. So that's the first thing. So when you're telling us things that we're simply not going to remember, we don't want to remember. Okay? So that's important. Also, you can't shock us. I mentioned before that I heard confessions for juvenile offenders for 10 years. And the juvenile delinquency situation involving the jails. And nobody here could match their confessions, trust me. Okay? Nothing you could say is going to shock us. So we want people to be honest and forthright in coming to the sacrament of penance because it builds grace in our lives to have this sacrament of penance, which we have here in this parish 6 days a week. Okay? Calling to mind God's goodness and grace. And then we move into the gospel, into this wonderful figure. What's his name? The doubter? Thomas. Okay? Because Thomas isn't in the room. So he says, I'm not going to believe that Jesus died and is returning back until what? Until I can see him. So Jesus says, we'll fix Thomas's wagon, baby. We're going to show up again. So the next week, they're in the upper room, still scared out of their minds, and Jesus shows up again. And says, Thomas, hey, come on over here. So Thomas walks up to him, and now, you know it's Jesus because what does he have in his hands? Wounds. What does he have on his feet? What's he got here? Sword, okay? And he goes, and he says, Thomas, come on over here. Thomas, of course, I'm sure is freaked out. So he says, put your hand right into here, okay? So Thomas puts his hand right into here, and he goes, the greatest act of faith in the New Testament is from Thomas the doubter, where he says, my Lord and my God. What does he say? My Lord and my God. A credible act of faith. And because of that, Thomas is a changed man. Anybody have doubters in their family? Wow. It's a big thing, isn't it? And people want to have, we want to have proof that he's God. Proof. Well, it's all about faith, isn't it? So we want people to feel God and Jesus working in this post-resurrection event. Jesus suffered for us, he died for us, and he's returning to us to say this, all of your sins are forgiven, everybody that goes to 10 o'clock Mass is saved, everybody here is going to ring the doorbell of heaven and get in, okay? And that's the truth. The grace is already there, okay? The grace of God is already there. Now, can you lose it? Yes. But it's hard to lose all the grace. So we're all saved, and we thank God for that, right? We want God to increase it as much as we can. So our prayer this week are the words of Thomas. What are they again?
My Lord and my God. So that's your opening prayer. And to all of your friends this week, dazzle them with this shalom. Shalom. Don't say, do you speak Hebrew? And you say, yes, I do. Shalom. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For I say he was crucified under Pontius Pilate, he suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, proceeds from the Father and the Son, who the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken to the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and life of the world to come. Amen. We have not seen, but still believe. With confident faith, we bring our concerns before God.
That the newly baptized and newly received find in the church both welcome and challenge, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For an end to armed conflict and to gun violence, so that all God's children may enjoy the peace that Jesus offers, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those seeking an increase in faith will grow in certainty that God's divine mercy, abundant beyond all human imagination, will be present, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the members of this community strive to be of one heart and mind in the risen Christ, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who are sick to be healed, for all the prayer intentions entered in our book here in the church, and for the prayers entered online, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the risen Christ will bring the dead to share in his victory, especially Ernesto Tapia, Antonio de Costa, Ana Maria de Costa, Raymond Higuera, Gregory Lovatier Jr., David Bautista, and Soledad C. Munoz, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We also pray for the following intention: Virginia Zavala, for whom this Mass is being offered, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We now pause in silence for our own personal intentions. we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
Generous God, plant your precious gift of faith ever deeper into our hearts this day through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Jubilate Deo, oh, be joyful in the Lord of your lands.
Jubilate, jubilate Deo, oh, be joyful in the Lord of your lands. We serve the Lord with gladness and come before his presence with a song. Be sure that the Lord is God. It is he that has made us and not we ourselves. Jubilate, jubilate Deo, oh, be joyful in the Lord all you lands. Jubilate, jubilate Deo, oh, be joyful in the Lord all you lands. We are his people.
Acceptable to God, our Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice of your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and for all his holy church.
Accept, O Lord, we pray, the oblation of your people, and renewed by the confession of your name and by baptism, they may retain unending happiness through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to claim you, O Lord, during this glorious season when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. For he is the true Lamb who has taken away the sins of the world. By dying, he has destroyed our death
and by rising restored our life. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise, and even the heavenly powers, the angelic host, sing together the unending hymn of your glory as we sing.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna, 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 Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna, 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 Hosanna in the highest.
Indeed, holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness, make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. Our mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, Jose our Bishop, and all our clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen, 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 amen.
Celebrate God's divine mercy and forgiveness to each of us, we pray these words.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom and the power and the glory are yours now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Him who takes away the sins of our world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter my room, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
And blessed.
Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that our reception of this Paschal Sacrament may have a continuing effect in our minds and hearts through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Just a few announcements. Our summer day camp is coming in July. The theme this year is scuba. You can check online or in the bulletin for more information about registration and details. Our bereavement ministry is in need of volunteers to help with funerals. We have approximately 100 to 125 funerals a year here in the parish. We'd like to be able to offer them hospitality and greeting the folks that when they come to the funerals, etc. So please consider the possibility of your volunteering for our bereavement ministry. More information online and also in the bulletin. You can still purchase a commemorative brick for our walkway. Please refer to the bulletin on our website. And don't forget to visit our gift shop, which is now open between 9 o'clock in the morning and 1:30 p.m. So our prayer for the week is four words.
My Lord, my God.
Not bad, that's impressive, really very impressive. And you can say hello to your friends by saying,
Shalom.
We can do that even better. It's one word, of course, that helps you. You got that. So stand, please. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Let God bless us, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.